California's eastern Sierras are filled with rugged beauty and offer plenty of adventure for those who are willing to take it on. Now, one such challenge is a mountain that stands taller than any other mountain in the continental U.S. and attracts adventurers from all over the world. Our very own David Wiley is one such adventurer as he takes us back to Mount Whitney.
Mount Whitney towers majestically over California's eastern Sierra Nevadas. As the tallest mountain in the lower 48 states, it had long been a goal of mine to hike the 14,500-foot peak. In 2008, I was able to scratch that wish off my bucket list.
Oh, that's one of the toughest things I've ever done in my life. The tallest mountain in the continental U.S., Mount Whitney. It's got my respect.
And while I was proud of my accomplishment, frankly, it was a grueling 22-mile hike that took more than 17 hours. I vowed that would be the first and last time I would make the treacherous trip. But time has a way of changing your mind. 2 years later, in late September of 2010, the mountain called my name, and I found myself hiking Mount Whitney once again. It was 4 a.m. as our group of eight assembled at the trailhead. Despite hiking the first few hours in the dark, the views were spectacular. The history of what we call Mount Whitney dates back nearly 150 years. It was named for state geologist Josiah Whitney back in 1864 after a failed attempt to climb the mountain by members of the California Geological Survey. The first successful ascent to the summit of Mount Whitney was accomplished by three local fishermen in 1873. While there were no signs of fishing poles as our group made its way up the Mount Whitney Trail under beautiful blue skies in late September. While we encountered great weather that day, the mountain is known for unpredictable conditions that can include rain, hail, and lightning. One of the most challenging stretches of the Mount Whitney Trail is the so-called 97 Switchbacks, which features a brutal ascent up the face of the mountain and includes a treacherous ice-covered area. As we reached trail crest more than 13,000 feet above sea level, the views opened up for miles, with alpine lakes and incredible rock formations and cliffs. From this point, the final 2 miles are much like a moonscape, rocky and barren. Breathing is difficult, as precious oxygen is depleted by the elevation. But finally, we spot the old rock building at the top of the mountain, a structure built by scientists at the turn of last century, signaling that our trek to the top was nearly finished. As we reached the summit, we signed the visitor's log, took time to rest and pose for a few photos, pictures that would preserve our memories of the pride and satisfaction of that long, long day. Despite this being my second hike of Mount Whitney, it wasn't any easier, and I found myself in the days and weeks following saying, never again. But I've said that before. There's no denying that there's something about Mount Whitney that draws you back. So while today I tip my hat and say so long, I've learned that with time, it's very hard to say goodbye to Mount Whitney. Bringing you the best of California, I'm David Wiley for California Life.